Hi everyone, welcome to another video where we strive together to achieve your dream score. Remember, the two-step process to achieve your dream GMAT score is that of structured preparation followed by mixed problem solving, and we will be focusing on mixed problem solving in this video. So over here we'll be discussing three questions of the same type so that you get good practice, and if you encounter a similar question on the GMAT, you would have sufficient practice and solid practice to actually solve it quickly in an accurate way. And towards the end of the video, we will try to analyze what we have learned and gather all of it together and ensure that it's solid and it's ready for being applied on the exam day. So let's get started, and do remember to subscribe to this channel, like this video if you like more such content, and let me know in the comments what you think of it, how's your preparation going, and I will reply to you. Alright, so let's get to the first question. So you have the first question on your screen. I'm giving you 2 minutes. Go ahead and give it a try, and then let's take a look at this question together. Alright, we are back. I hope you have given it a try. Now let's solve this question together. It says a particular brand of cooking oil must be purchased either in 250 ml bottles for $2 each or in 1 liter bottles for $6 each. Alright, so these are the two options. Then it goes on to say a chef needs a 3 liter mixture of oil consisting of 2 parts of olive oil and 3 parts of sunflower oil. What is the least amount of money needed to purchase sufficient quantities of the two types of oil to make the mixture? So ultimately, this particular chef is going to have 3 liters, and we'll have to see in what proportion he has to buy the two oils, olive oil and sunflower oil, and it should also follow the ratio which is mentioned over here, which is 2:3. But before we go ahead to that, we know that ultimately he's going to have 3 liter mixture, right? So let's just take a look at what's the range of the cost. So to see whether we actually even need to solve this question or can we eliminate the wrong option. So that's why I'm just trying to find the range over here. And also notice it's easy to find the range over here because the cost of olive oil and the sunflower oil is the same. The packets are, the cost of the packets is applicable for both. So ultimately the 3 liters is either going to come from 3 1-liter bottles, which would make the cost 3:6, or it could come from 4:3, because 1 liter is 4 packets of 250 ml, right? So 3 liters would be 4:3, which is 12 packets of 250 ml. So, and the cost of 250 ml is $2 each. So the range of the cost has to be between 3:6, which is 18, and 12:2, which is 24. So anything which is outside this range, which you can see these two options over here, right? So that's definitely not possible, and we can eliminate those. All right, now let's proceed and go ahead with the question. So over here it says, what is the least amount of money needed to purchase the sufficient quantities of the two types of oil? So we will be needing to maximize buying oil in 1 liters, because as you can see, 1 liter bottle costs $6. Now to get to 1 liter through 250 ml bottles, you would have to buy 4 bottles, and that would be 4:2, which is $8, right? So if you can buy in 1 liter bottles, you have a lower cost. So we have to maximize buying in 1 liter bottles. Alright, now over here, we know that ultimately it's going to be 3 liters, and I'm going to write this 3 liters in terms of the lower possible unit over here, which is 250 ml. So I can say that 3 liters is 3:4, or 12 units in 250 ml. Now the reason why I'm doing this, you could do this in terms of liter as well, but if you go with the lower unit, it is easier to like if you're reaching a decimal fraction after you do the split, it is easier to go ahead one step to add one quantity more. Now we will see that when, as we proceed with the question. So far over here, bear with me. So we are taking the units in terms of 250 ml, which is the lower unit. Now it's mentioned that olive oil and sunflower oil has to be in the ratio 2:3. So if you, for example, if you have 2 liters of olive oil, you would have 5 liters of sunflower oil. But again, that's just an example. As seen over here, we don't need 2+3, 5 liters. We ultimately need only 3 liters, or 3:4, which is 12 packets of 250 ml, or 12 quantities of 250 ml. And again, it's one and the same. Saying 3 liters or 12 into 250 ml is one and the same. So we are going to divide this quantity over here in the ratio 2:3. All right. So if we do that, now again over here we have 2:3. So the total, like if something is divided in the ratio 2:3, it's equivalent to saying divide that particular thing into 2 + 3 equal to 5 equal parts, and then take 2 parts and put it over here. Or it's the same as saying have 2/5 over here and 3/5 over here, right? So if you take the ratio of 2/5:3/5, you will get 2:3. And that's the ratio that we need over here. All right. And it's 2/5 of what? Of the thing that we are dividing in this ratio, right? So it's 2/5 × 12. And similarly, it's 3/5 × 12. Now 2/5 × 12, that's 4 × 4/5. Right, this is 24/5, or that's same as 4 × 4/5, and 3/5 × 12 is 7 × 1/5. Now again over here you can't buy 4/5 of a 250 ml bottle, right? So this is equivalent to saying that we need 5 bottles of 250 ml, and over here we have again 1/5 extra after 7, so we can say that that's equivalent to buying 8 packets of 250 ml. All right, so we know that the quantity that we need over here is 5 and 8 in terms of 250 ml. Now the reason why this is helpful is that, again, this is not in terms of liters. If it was in terms of liters, we would have to check the fraction and see whether that, how much equivalent of 250 ml that would be. We can't simply increase it by 1. But over here it's easy to increase it by 1 because we definitely need 4, and then we need 4/5 of a 250 ml packet, and there is no such option, right? There is nothing smaller than 250 ml, so definitely it's easy to increase it by 1, and we get 5 over here. Now this 5 over here can be written as 4 + 1, because why am I taking out 4 from it? Because 4 250 ml can be converted into 1 1-liter bottle, right? That's why this 5 is equal to 4 + 1. So this 4, to satisfy this quantity, I'll just buy 1 liter, 1 1-liter bottle, and for this quantity I will buy 1 bottle of 250 ml, and the cost for this would be $6, and the cost for this would be $2 as per the question. All right, now what about this part over here? I need 8 bottles of 250 ml, and that's just representative of the quantity required. So for this I can just buy 2 bottles of 1 liter, right? So the cost would be $2 × $6. So that's it. So that gives us the answer. So the cost over here is $8, and this is 12. So the total cost is 12 + 8, which is equal to $20, which is option B. All right. So just take a moment and try to think about what we just did over here. We tried to find the range and eliminated the wrong options. Then we divided the required quantity in the required ratio. And then once, and over here I've taken it in the lower quantity, in terms of the lower available quantity of the bottles. Like I could do this like in terms of liters as well. You could divide 3 liters in the ratio 2:3 as well. But if you do it in this manner, it's easier over here. You can see when you get to the fraction, there is nothing smaller than 250 ml which is available. So we can just increase this by 1 and get to 5. So that's why it's helpful to convert whatever you're dividing into the, in terms of the lower available quantity. And then we just try to maximize the 1 liter bottles, and we arrived at the respective costs. All right. So you have learned this. Now it's very useful if you go ahead and attempt the 2 more questions which are there in this video, so that you get thorough with these type of questions, and this becomes something that is strong in your arsenal. If you get a similar question, you are sure to do it accurately and correctly in a quick manner. All right, so let's get to question number 2. And over here on the screen, you have question number 2. I'm giving you 2 minutes. Go ahead and give it a try, and then let's take a look at this question together. All right, we're back. I hope you've given it a try. Now let's read the question. It says a specific brand of engine oil must be purchased either in quarts at $10 each or in gallons at $32 each. A mechanic needs 4-gallon mixture of oil consisting of 1 part synthetic and 2 parts regular. All right. What is the least amount of money needed to purchase sufficient quantities of the two types to make the mixture, and it's given that 4 quarts is equal to 1 gallon. Alright, so that's the information in the question. Now, let's proceed. Again, over here we need to find the least money required, and for that we need to maximize buying in terms of gallons because that's cheaper, right? So, 1 quart costs $10, so 4 quarts cost $40, but if we buy 1 gallon, that's just $32. So that's why we will maximize buying in terms of gallons. Now, let's proceed. Let me just write this over here. We are trying to maximize buying in terms of gallons. Now, before we start and solve the question, let's just take a look at the range over here. We ultimately are going to buy 4 gallons, right? So, this 4 gallons could be either completely in terms of gallons, in which case the cost would be 4 into 32, or it could be completely on the lower, on the higher side in terms of cost, in terms of quarts, right? So, 4 gallons would be 4 into 4, 16 quarts. So, the cost would be 4 into 4 into 10. So, the range is 4 into 32 to 4 into 4 into 10. Now, 4 into 32, that's 128, and 4 into 4 into 10, that is 160. So, the range has to be, the correct answer choice has to be in this range. Now, anything outside this range can be eliminated. So, we can eliminate option A and we can eliminate option E. Alright, so let's proceed and go ahead, because we are left still with 3 more options. We need to go ahead and solve this. Now, it's good to know this, checking the range, because in some questions you may see that once you do this, every option is eliminated except one option, and you can directly go ahead and mark that answer. So that's why this is helpful. Now, over here we have 4 gallons which needs to be divided in the ratio 1:2. Now, instead of in terms of gallons, I'm going to take this in terms of the lower unit, which is quarts. So 4 gallons is nothing but 16 quarts. So I'm going to divide 16 quarts in the ratio 1:2, and we have seen in the previous video why it is beneficial to take this in terms of quarts rather than gallons. Now, if I'm dividing this in the ratio 1:2, the total number of parts is 1+2, and this over here would be 1/3, and this over here would be 2/3, and 1/3 of what? 1/3 of this 16. So that's how you get 16 over here, and 2/3 of what? 2/3 of this 16. That's how you get this 16 over here. Notice that if you take the ratio of these two, the 16s will cancel out, the 3s will cancel out, and you will be left with 1:2, which is the ratio that we need as per what is mentioned over here. Alright, so in terms of quarts, this is the quantity of synthetic and regular, right? Synthetic and regular oil, mixture of oil. So this is the ratio of the quantity. Now, 16/3 is nothing but 5 1/3, and 2/3 into 16 is nothing but 10 2/3. This is 32/3, right? So 32/3 is 10 2/3. Now, because we can't go any way further down rather than the quart, right? So there is no smaller unit mentioned in the question in which you can buy this oil. So you can't buy 1/3 of a quart. So we just increase this to 1. So this becomes 6. And similarly, this over here becomes 11. Alright, now we need to buy 6 quarts. Now this can be bought as 6 can be rewritten as 4+2. And I'm doing this because 4 quarts is 1 gallon and we want to maximize buying in gallons. So instead of buying 4 quarts, I'll just buy 1 gallon which costs $32. And then the remaining 2, I'll buy 2 quarts which is 2 into $10, which is the cost of the synthetic part. Now, what about the regular part over here? I need 11 quarts. Now, 11 can be rewritten as 8+3. So, I'm taking maximum multiples of 4 out, right? So, you could take it as 4+4+3 as well. So, 4+4, that's equivalent to 2 gallons. Or this 8 over here is equivalent to 2 gallons. And then for the remaining 3, I'll buy 3 quarts. So, 2 gallons will cost $2 into $32. And 3 quarts will cost $3 into $10. And that gives us the answer. We just need to add these up. So 32 plus 20 is 52. Similarly, 2 into 32, which is 64 plus 30 gives 94. And then I just need to add 94 and 52. And the answer is 146, which is answer option C. Alright, so take a moment and try to think in your mind what we just did over here. So we understood that we need to maximize gallons. We found the range, eliminated options outside the range, and then we divided the number of quarts required. We took it in terms of quarts because it's easier over here once you get to the fraction part. And then we divided in the ratio required and we tried to maximize gallons. So that's what we did over here and here. The correct answer is option C. Now, you've done two questions of the same type. I'm pretty sure you've got a good understanding of handling these type of questions. Now, let's take a look at one more question. So you have the question on your screen. Take a moment. I'm giving you 2 minutes. Try to attempt this question on your own. And then let's take a look at this question together. All right, we are back. I hope you have given it a try. Now, let's take a look at this question together. A certain brand of protein powder must be purchased either in 200 gram packets at $4 each or in 1 kilogram packets at $15 each. A bodybuilder needs a 2 kilogram mixture of protein powder consisting of 3 parts whey and 2 parts casein. Alright, what is the least amount of money needed to purchase sufficient quantities of the two types to make the mixture? And it's given that 5 packets of 200 gram is equal to 1 kilogram. Again, that's something that we would even otherwise know. Now, before we start over here, let's just take a look at the range which is possible. So ultimately, it's going to be a 2 kilogram mixture, which could be 2 1 kilogram packets, in which case it would be 15 into 2, and it could be 2 into 5, that is 10 packets of 200 gram, right? So that would be 10 into 4, because the cost of each packet is 4. So the range is 30 to 40, right? So any answer which is outside this range, which is these two answers, can be eliminated. So we are left with 3 more options. Now, we need 2 kilograms ultimately, and in terms of the lower quantity packet, which is 200 gram packets, that's 2 into 5, which is 10, right? So this 10 over here has to be divided in the ratio 3:2 between whey and casein. All right. So if you're doing that, the total number of parts over here would be 3 plus 2, which is 5. So this over here will be 3 by 5, and this would be 2 by 5, right? 3 by 5 and 2 by 5 of the initial amount that we're dividing. So 3 by 5 into 10 and 2 by 5 into 10. So this over here simplifies to 6 and this simplifies to 4. Now this 6 over here can be rewritten as 5 plus 1. So instead of buying 5 packets of 200 gram, I'll just buy 1 packet of 1 kilogram, which costs me $15. And then for this one, I'll buy 1 packet of 200 gram, which costs $4. All right. Now, what about this 4 over here? This 4 does not have one complete 5, right? So this 4, instead of, I can't, in this way of thinking, it does not make up to 1 kilogram. So if I just buy 4 packets of 200 gram, you'll see that the cost is 4 into 4, which is 16. But this over here is a trap. When you do this, when you buy some numbers of the lower packet, you should ensure that the cost does not go greater than the cost of the higher packet. So even if 4 into 4 is only 800 grams, it costs $16, which is more than the cost of 1 kilogram. So rather than buying 800 gram, even though some amount of the protein would be wasted, it would still be more economical. That means less money would be required if I just go ahead and buy 1 kilogram, right? So in this case, because this 16 is greater than the cost of 1 kilogram, we will not buy 4 packets of 200 gram, but rather go with 1 packet of 1 kilogram, which costs $15. Now, this is a trap. So if you did not take care of this trap, you would have marked the answer as 35, because 15 plus 4 is 19 and 19 plus 16 is 35. But that's not the answer. It's 19 plus 15, which is equal to 34. So this is an important thing. All right. So we have seen these 3 questions. Now let's take a look and analyze what we have learned and just summarize it to ourselves, so that whatever we have learned is solid in our mind and it's ready to be used on the day of the exam. Now do remember to subscribe so that whenever we release content, it'll be useful for you and you'll be notified, and you can quickly take some time out of your busy schedule and just quickly practice some random questions, some mixed problem solving to solidify your learning. All right. So let's come back to the analysis for this video. So one thing that we've discussed over here is, if you want to divide something in a ratio, how do you do this? For example, if you want to divide 10 in the ratio 2:3, so 2 parts and 3 parts. So the total number of parts would be 5 parts. And out of the 5 parts, you give 2 over here, which is 2 by 5. and over here three parts, which is 3 by 5, right? So this would be 2 by 5 into the initial amount which you are dividing, which is this 10 over here. This would be 3 by 5 into this 10 over here. This is something that we have discussed in this video. Another thing that we discussed is, in these type of questions you may have two types of measurements, like 250. In one question we had packets of bottles of 250 ml and 1 liter. In another question we had quarts and gallons, or we had 200 gram and 1 kilogram, etc. So when you do this division, you can take this initial quantity in terms of the lower packet or in terms of the higher packet. But it is beneficial to do it in terms of the lower packet, because if you get to a fraction, once you apply the ratio, then you can't go any way further down, because you have already applied the lower packet, and that will help you easily just add 1 to the whole number of the fraction to get to the number of packets required before you try to maximize the higher packet. Alright, so that's what something that we have seen in the previous 3 questions. And finally, in question number 3, we discussed a trap. You have to ensure that the cost of the number of smaller units is not greater than the cost of a larger unit, because in question number 3 we saw that we did not require the 1 kilogram, which was the larger quantity. We only required 800 gram, but the cost of 1 kilogram was less than the cost of 800 gram by buying 4 smaller packets. So it was more economical to just go ahead and buy the 1 kilogram thing. So this is something that you need to keep in mind. This is a trap that can be set in different questions. All the best in your preparation, and do remember to subscribe, like this video if you want more such content, and if you want this coming consistently your way, do like this video and support us, and let me know in the comments what is going on in your preparation, and I will personally reply to you. All the very best.